Hello everyone, I hope everyone is off to a good start to their summer. So I'm going to start with a product from a new brand of makeup that I recently discovered. It's called Moonshot, and this is a Korean brand that's owned by an entertainment company here in Korea called YG. It's called Color Moonwalk Cream Paint, and this is in the color 104 Pink Punch. This is a product that you can use on your cheeks and on your lips, and it has the most beautiful powdery finish that's still moist. I love everything about, okay, I don't love everything about this product. There's one thing that I really hate about this product, which is the packaging. When I open it, it has this huge applicator. It's so big and so much of the product comes out. I feel like I just pulled out like a quarter of the product that was in the pot. And it's so pigmented that you need very, very, very little that there's no use for this much product. Every time I pull this out, it does kind of set pretty fast. I've tried products like products from Makeup Forever, those cream ones that set super fast. So it's not as fast as that, but still you have to work pretty fast to kind of blend it out. And once they are on your cheeks, it will last all day long. Price comparison to brands like Etude House or what else is there, like Tony Moly and those kind of brands, this brand is more pricey overall, but I feel like the quality is really good. I just hope they decide to change like the packaging, at least this applicator. This really has to go. It's making it all messy too. Another product that I've been really loving is this brow product from Fairy Drop. It has this pencil liner that you just roll up. I hate those pencil liners that you have to sharpen. I love the Shumera brow liners. Mochi! So I love those Shumera pencil liners. I love the texture of it, how it just sketches on, but I hate the fact that I have to always sharpen it. And this one, it's a slightly more waxier than the Shumera one because the Shumera ones are very dry. That's why it's easy to really like sketch it on. And for me, I do prefer the drier ones as opposed to the waxier brow pencils because I have a lot of brow hairs. It's just that I have a few missing spots that I need to kind of fill in. So this is perfect. It draws like really natural looking lines and it has this other end. Has this brow mascara. It has like a very small one, but there's a good amount in there. I've been using this a lot and I feel like it's still full. And I picked the color light brown because even though my hair is not light brown, I like to kind of lighten my brows with lighter looking brows, like lighter and natural looking brows. My features look softer. My face looks somewhat softer. Yeah, so that's what I like these days. Oh, one more thing. The reason why I like this kind of brow pencil is that after I sketch it on, I really don't have to do anything. If I don't want to use the mascara part, the brow mascara part to lighten my brows, I could just leave it. It looks natural enough. Whereas when I use those waxier pencils, I find that I have to take like these kind of spoolie things like this and kind of rub it to make it look natural. So I recently repurchased a Shiseido lash curler. I use the Shiseido one and the Shumera one and I like them both. And I feel like those two are the best ones that I found so far, but I feel like there has to be something better. I tried two different ones in the past 6 months and they both didn't work out. That's why I ended up rebuying this Shiseido lash curler. And yes, I'm happy with it, but I'm just on this search to find something better. So if you guys know of a lash curler that worked really well for you or something that you think that I might like, please let me know. Next product is this Bobbi Brown eyeshadow primer, I think it's called. It's called Longwear Eye Base. Longwear Eye Base. Okay, so these products come in different colors. I think here in Korea, there's only light and medium. I love the fact that it gives a little bit of color so that it kind of gets rid of the discoloration on my eyes. It evens out the tone of my eyelids before I put the eyeshadows on. And, you know, it does make my lashes, I mean, not my lashes, but it does make my eyeshadows look more pigmented, but it's so not long wear. It doesn't extend the wear of my eyeshadows. It does a little bit, but I've tried so many other eyeshadow primers that did way better. My favorite still is the NARS Pro Prime Eye Base, I think it's called Eye Base. I've been getting kind of back into contouring and stuff because it's becoming so popular lately, right? All I see is those contouring videos, like before and after, how dramatic it is. So yeah, I used to do a lot of contouring, like way back when I was doing makeup for other people and like get makeup. So for myself, I didn't do so much, but I'm kind of getting back into it. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna pick up a contouring shade because I didn't really bring any when I moved to Korea. So I picked up this one, and this is, as the name suggests, it's a bronzing powder. It's bronzing brown. So I feel like people are just getting into contouring here, so they're not they don't have a lot of contouring products yet, and I'm warm tone, but I still need to use gray, like cool tone. I don't mean to say I'm gonna use black or gray on my face, but contouring is all about creating shades and making your making some parts of your face kind of recede. When you use a bronzing product to contour, I mean, it still works, but it's not as effective. This is a good product. It's very pigmented. I like the line of blushers that they have at Tony Moly, but this particular product for contouring doesn't create the shadows that I want by contouring, but I still use it. I've been using it, you know, not really to contour, but just to kind of like, you know, shade down this area. That's what Koreans do, so that's what I've been doing too. So I'm very excited that one of my friends here in Korea is going to, or she already left, to go to US, and I've asked her to purchase some products for me from like Sephora and Nordstrom and stuff like that. And also I think I asked her to go to Ulta as well. So I wanted to know if you guys know of any good contouring palettes or product, please let me know, because she's gonna be there for a month, so I can still let her know. Lastly, this is gonna be a bit of a rant because it's about this product here, Sisley Black Rose, what is it called? Black Rose Precious Face Oil, which I love the actual product. I did a full review of this as well as the Black Rose Cream Mask from Sisley, and I love using that and this, like the cream mask and this oil as a set. But about a month or two after I did that review, I started to run out of the product and it was very little left, and I tried to get the product out and I can't get it out because the dropper doesn't reach all the way down. I can't even like shift it and like maneuver this dropper to attempt to get this product out. It's just there. So what I have to do is take this whole thing out and drop it on my hand. And when I do that, it starts dripping all over here and I just end up wasting a lot of the product. And it's just been a mess. This bottle right now is all greasy. And you would think from a brand like Sisley, they charge you so much for all their products, including this bottle. They should make packaging bottles that's more functional than this. This is so hard to get the product out, and when I reviewed this, I didn't realize it. I guess from now on I should kind of think about those kind of stuff too. But I thought the packaging was fine. I was like, oh, it's just a little dropper. My dog's here. I don't know what he wants. I think I do know what he wants. He wants some treats. Yeah, so I wanted to ask you guys, did you guys ever buy a product and really love the product, really, really love the product, but you just absolutely hated the packaging? So that's it for my main hits and misses. I hope you guys all have a great day, and I will see you guys in my next video.